That was a pretty dominant performance tonight. You know, how would you kind of rate that performance in your own mind?
It was really good, you know. I knew that Smoke is a really, really tough opponent. I got him with really clean shots, and he kept fighting, you know. Even when he got knocked down, he was like not even trying to survive, but he was trying to submit me. So I was kind of surprised with that. But I think it was a good challenge for me, you know, and I could show why I'm here, fight with the top guys in the world.
Where do you think a performance like that puts you next? Have an opponent in mind? Do you have a roadmap of what you'd like to do next?
Not yet. What I know is that I want to fight with the best. You know, I think that victory put me with in the top 15. Of course, before I was ranked top 10, and now I just beat the top 13. So I think that I'm top 10 again. And I don't know who's gonna be my next step in my career. Right now, I just want to enjoy that victory, you know, and then sit with my team and see what's gonna be the next step. But I'm pretty sure that I want a ranked guy. And as I said before, I'm all the way up, you know. I'm thinking high, of course.
You had him very hurt at the end of the first round. Are you surprised how tough he was and survived all the way through all three rounds?
I knew that he was a really, really tough opponent, you know. But I was kind of surprised, man. Three knockdowns in one round, you know, and a big cut, and he still, like I said, he was not just trying to survive, but he was trying to submit me even when he was out of the fight. So this got me kind of surprised, but I keep the game playing, I keep cool, you know, I didn't try to rush things, and I think I did a good job.
What was the game?
The game plan was basically put my weapons on top of his game. I knew that he is a very solid ground game, and he's like to put the rhythm in. So I didn't want to let him put the rhythm in the fight. And being a taller opponent that he is, I knew that body shot would be a good way for get the victory, and that was what I did. You know, instead of trying to look for his head first, I was trying to look for his body first, make him slow, and then look for his head. And I think that I did right and got the victory.
This was your first fight since July of 2016. You had the USADA issue. Can you give us your side of the story there and what it has been like dealing with that and trying to get over it?
Yeah, it was a really, really tough moment of my career, of course. I didn't expect that. I could expect to be hurt and anything, but not the doping stuff. And just happened with me. I don't know if you know the case about how it was. The amount was really low amount of anastrozole. Everybody, those other guys, soon as he saw my case, they said to me, hey, this is something tainted and everything. But it is what it is, you know. You have to... The process have to keep going the way it is. So it was a really tough moment of my career, but I think the tough moment is what makes us harder. And I grew up a lot in that time that I was away from the octagon, you know, not just as a man, but as a martial artist, you know. And now I'm back, and I think that I'm back a better martial artist and better man and ready for a big challenge.
I noticed that you tweeted, you know, the flyweight division needs someone to take over. You feel like it's a little stale. What were you trying to say there? Because, of course, you have the champion who's been so dominant. What were you trying to say?
I'm trying to say that I'm here to put some fun in that division, you know. I think they needed a new blood, and I am the new blood, you know. I'm pretty sure that I have all the skills that I need to go, as I say, all the way up. And of course, I think step by step, you know, I have a big road into the top of the division, but I'm pretty sure that I can put a lot of fun in that division, you know.
Anyone who makes sense for you as a particular name? I know you talked about rankings and whatnot, but is there a fight that makes
sense? Yeah, right now I don't have a name, but as I say, I want a ranked guy, yeah. Of course, but for now I want to enjoy that victory. No, it was like a really tough year. I think I deserve the time for enjoy a little bit, enjoy the New Year's, and then I'm going to sit with my team and see exactly who's going to be the next step of my career. But as I said before, I want a ranked name, of course.
And just curious, I know you're now with you know, Eduardo Alonso, you have guys like Damian Maia around you. For a young guy like yourself to be around people who have been around the sport for so long, how has that helped you?
helped me a lot, you know. And it's not just now. Before that, I was in the Nova Union. I was there for 5 years, training with Renan Barão, José Formiga, Aldo, Eduardo Dantas, you know. I always try to train with the best guys, you know, with the champions. After this, I went to Jackson Wink, and then I have a very, very good trainers over there. And now I'm in DMMI, Vila da Luta in São Paulo, and I think I just... Right now I discover where it's my home is, you know. I'm really happy over there. I think I have the best training camp for a fight, you know. Everything was really, really specific, and I'm just honored to be where I am right now.
Parabéns.
Thank you.